接下来现在, you follow the last video, okay? Continue talking about Confucius, 孔子. But we're still not there yet, right? No worries, we need to talk something Chinese story. Because China is what? Old country. In Chinese, we say what? 中国是一个非常非常 very, very, 古老的国家. Don't say 老的国家, 古老的国家, 是一个非常古老的国家. We need to talk some background, the story here, for the story, for country. 我们得讲一点中国的历史. Then we can continue talking about the Confucius, 孔子. Then you're feeling comfortable. 你会比较容易的 understand, 理解, 或者明白, who is 孔子. 孔子, 好. Now, last video, we already talking about 孔子的 family, right? 孔子的爸爸, 苏良鹤, 孔子的妈妈, 颜真在, 都记住了啊, we not here, right? 那孔子三岁的时候, 爸爸死了, 那孔子非常聪明, 17岁的时候, 妈妈也死了, 后来孔子 study, right? Study, 读书,学习,学习, 他又办了一个学校, 一个 school, 他就教书, 他就教书, is teacher, 是一个老师, 教了很多学生, 他的学生有多少呢? 有3000多个学生, 有多少个非常聪明, 非常好的学生呢? 非常有贤能的弟子呢? 72个, 72个, 以前的学生, 人家学生 student, we don't say 学生, we say 弟子, 弟子, 3000多弟子, 其中, in the here, 有72个, 非常聪明的, 非常好的弟子, 非常好的学生. 那孔子是在什么时候生活呢? 春秋战国时期, let's see here, you can read that character, right? 春秋战国, 春秋 is a part, 战国是一个 part, 春秋是一段时间, 战国是一段时间. Now, maybe you're confused, ask me, say, 孔子, Confucius, 孔子, 孔丘, now we can say 孔丘, because you know his name is not 孔子, right? His name is 孔丘, right? Okay, 孔丘是在春秋还是在战国? Last video, I already said that. He's born in the 春秋时期, he dies 战国, 所以我们说, 孔丘, 孔丘, 孔丘是春秋战国时期, this time, this term, 这个时期的什么人? 那个国家是鲁国人, 为什么叫春秋? 为什么叫战国? We're talking later, okay? So first figure out, 他是鲁国人, 是现在的山东曲阜, 意思他是山东人, 山东人, 北方人, 山东人, 山东曲阜人, 那过去的山东, 那个地方, 山东曲阜, 是鲁国的一个地方, 叫鲁国, 我们就是鲁国人, 就可以了。 那为什么叫春秋战国呢? 那段时间, 为什么叫春秋战国呢? Okay, 春秋是一本书的名字, 叫春秋, 就春秋编年史, 有一本书的名字叫春秋编年史, 这个书, 春秋编年史, what is the meaning? 编年史是编辑, 编辑什么的呢? 什么呢? 年史, 每年发生的事情, 每年有点像现在的 news, 你看, keep the everyday the news, okay? 这本书是春秋，这本书的讲的是什么？编年史，就是每年发生的事儿，每天发生的事儿。 I'll prefer say 每年发生的事儿。 Why you say 是每年，然后say每天 ？Okay, let's figure out 我们的春秋。 春 is spring, 秋 is autumn or fall. Before long time, 春秋 together. We see that right here. This means a year, 1 year. 一个春秋, 1 year have 1 spring and 1 autumn and fall, right? We drop the summer or winter, but still means we just say 春秋 means 1 year. Or only say 春 1 year, 秋 1 year. Because 1 year have one time the seasons. We have four seasons, but only have one season for spring, right? That means I say 春, okay? Or you can only say 秋, 1 year only have one season for what? Autumn, right? 秋. Or you can say together, 春秋. But why they don't say summer and autumn like dropped 春秋? Because 春 is start beginning warm, right? Okay, for the temperature, for the weather, for the plant. They can grow up. 秋, the plant have the fruit. We have fruit, we can't eat, so some overall done finished, right? We like to use the 春秋, and that's it, 春秋. Okay, the book, they say, 春秋编年史. The book talking, 编年史, what does it mean? That's a book talking about every year happens or some things for this time. Okay, what time? Okay, the year we can see, let me try to remember, it's 2000, no, not 2000, okay. So we will say BC, okay, before Christ. Before Christ, okay. Let's figure out here, before Christ, okay. So in Chinese, you say BC, okay, before Christ. In Chinese, we say 公元, use Christ. Chinese, we say 公元. Before Chinese, we say 前. 公元前. Now, 公元, Chinese say 公元, okay, here, 公元元年, okay, just Christ, the year, Chinese, we say 元年, we say the full name, we like to say 公元元年, you plus before, Chinese, we say 公元前, 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 after 公元元年, 公元, we don't say zero, we say 元年, the Christ year. Okay, you say the Christ, Chinese say 元年, 元年, okay, 元年. Now after 元年, okay, we say before one, 公元一年, 公元 before, 公元 don't forget to say 前, 公元前一年, 公元前二年, the small number go to bigger number, right? It's a bigger number means very far from, because we plus 公元一年, 公元二年, 公元前, don't forget the 公元, before BC, 公元前, 公元前一年, 公元前二年, 公元前三年, the number bigger means more far, from here to there, more far. 公元前三年, okay, finally, we say here, right? So the 春秋 is 公元, 春秋战国时期 from to the 公元770年, 77 to 476. This part time, we say 春秋, 春秋. Why we say 春秋? Again, you can feel why they say 春秋. We say this time again, before 公元前770年 to 476. 公元前476年, they have one book. The books we say 春秋. That's 春秋. We talk about every year what they happen. In Chinese, we say 春秋编年史. The name for Chinese name, we say 春秋编年史. Okay, the year from before 公元前770 to 476. They talk about this term, this time, what happened for every year. The book say 春秋编年史. Then that's why they keep the book name, say this part, this year, this whole year, between this year, which is 春秋. the name from this book. Why they from this book? Because this book, they talk every year, 什么意思? Truth story. Truth happens, so 什么意思? They just keep this name, the book from, the name from the book for this part, this time, say 春秋. Okay, the 孔子 is born this term, the year, okay? When he's born, 551, okay? 春秋 from the 717, between for 476, and cover 551. That's 孔子 from there, right? Okay, then we can say 孔子是春秋. They work? Yes. Then you know why this time we talk about 春秋. This year, we say 春秋 from this book. This book talking every year the true story and what happened. Who see died? The professor. What professor? The major, they study for the history, the professor. They write, they say, okay, this part in China, the history, we give them as 春秋 from the book, from the 春秋 编年史, this book. We can hear? Okay, the next part, next one. After 476年, okay, then that means 475年 to 221, okay. This part, the professor, the historian, the professor, they say this part, say what the name, 战国. Why? Because this couple years, this few years, the country always fight, okay? And also now from to the professor, still, we are 战国. Why? You fight me, I fight you for the country. This country fight another country. Another country fight this country. They just say, we are 战国. Then the writers for story writers say, okay, we say this time we 战国. And 孔子 is dies this part. When he dies 479, and cover, okay, he died this year, is in what year? 战国 is 475, he dies 479, okay, that means 战国, 孔子, 春秋, 战国时期, this part. Okay, here, then, what countries? We talk about the time, right? 汝国人, they have seven countries. One country is 汝国, 孔子 is 汝国人. 孔子汝国人. Okay, here? Okay. Just talking something. Why they talking about the 春秋? Why the name they talking 战国? The 战国 from the country by the country. Okay. They are writer. For the professor, okay, for the story, the writer, they say, okay, this time, this part, we talk on 战国. Okay. Then 春秋 from the book, they have the book. This time, because the book talking the time is from the 770 to 476. This is story, true story, every year. 春秋 means year, right? Means every year, right? Okay. So, okay, we talk on this part, you see, 春秋. That's 春秋 first, after 春秋, let me see, 战国. That means 春秋 more far for us, 战国 more close for us. Remember, we talk about the BC, okay? BC, Chinese is 公元前, the number is bigger, means far, more far for us. The number small, more close for BC, okay? Okay, you say before Christ. Okay, here? Okay, also Christ, Chinese say what? Then you can see down here, okay? Chinese, in Chinese, we say 基督. You say Christ? Yeah. 基督 or you can say 主 OK Christ OK you can say 基督年基督的那年 OK or you can say 主的那年 In Chinese we don't say 基督年 we don't say 主年 we say what we say 元年元年 we like to say 公元元年 the Chinese OK the Chinese say 公元元年 just you say theChrist, okay, before Christ, just Christ. 公元元年 before Christ, 前 we say 公元前 But Christ, the translation is means 基督 or 主 Because you say 基督年主年 Chinese say what? 公元元年 We okay here? Christ, Chinese say 公元元年 Okay, or you say Christ, Chinese, we can say基督年 or 主年 both the word before 孔子 from the before BC before we'll get here 春秋 OK let's finish here 春秋 right then confused they say but we know that China has a big it's a very old country right it's long stories right long stories and before 春秋 they have something thereThe answer is yes. And that's why we already say how long Chinese the story. I can say 490 years. Okay. Now 400. 4,090 years. Okay. 4,090 years. How I know that one here? We check here. Okay. Let's check here. Okay.Before 春秋, China have the what? Dynasty. The first dynasty, we say what? We say 夏. 夏朝. 朝 is dynasty, right? 朝 is dynasty. And the first dynasty, Chinese, we say 夏朝. Let me see. I see how this one here. 夏朝. Then 夏朝 from to when?When is 夏朝 When is 夏朝 Let's see here. Let's see down here. 夏朝夏朝 is in China as the first dynasty. Maybe you know this character. 夏 summer. 夏夏天的夏 or summer 的夏姓夏的夏 summer 的 last name. And for the seasons, 夏 summer. 朝 dynasty.In that case, somebody last name, 夏朝 夏朝 okay. 夏 dynasty is China the first dynasty. From the when? 2070 BC. In Chinese, we say, 公元前 Don't forget, say that one here. You say BC, right? Chinese, we say, 公元前 公元前 Or you can say,基督前 or 主前 you have plus the 前 means before, right? But in Chinese, very popular, we say 公元前公元前 2070 2070年2070年 yeah, before, okay? 2070年 Now we are as aChrist after, right? Okay, 公元公元后前 is 后 What year is year? 2020, right? 2020 Okay, how long the stories? We need a plus 2070 2070 plus the 2020 2020 Wow 4090, okay, 40, okay, then 90. See, look, then you can see China is old now, old, definitely. Yes, very old country. 中国是非常非常古老的国家。How long? 多长? You can say, 有四千九十年。四千零九十年的 历史，very long，4000多年，maybe is 4000 and more。4000 more, more than 4000，有4000多年的历史，从哪开始的？From when？夏 dynasty，OK，夏 dynasty，夏朝，OK，we finish 夏朝 here. Then how about 春秋战国？OK，we want to contact here, right？春秋战国，夏好浪的夏。夏 is okay. 夏 start 2070, then it finished 1600, 1600年. Okay, 夏 is the term is 400. That means after the 夏 dynasty, we have another dynasty. The answer is yes. After 夏. We have which one? You can see down here, okay? 夏, then 商, 商, 夏, 商, then after 商 dynasty, we say 周, then from the 孔子, 春秋战国, finally, you are there. One more time here. 孔子 from to 春秋战国, before 春秋, It's what? Zhou dynasty. Before Zhou dynasty, it's Shang dynasty. Before Shang dynasty, it's Chinese or China, the first dynasty. It's Xia. I just show you guys right now. Xia. Xia is the first. And for the year, BC year, 2070. Okay, now we know. Now we are 2020. It's together 4019. The story is very old country. 那那个时候是什么社会呢? We say 世袭制. I don't know that. I know you don't. We figure out here, okay? 世袭制, the rule, the law, the follow. 世袭制是什么样的 security 呢? Chinese, we say 世袭制 The 世袭制的 meaning is If you are 大王 We don't say king, okay? 就是 big person The 王 The top one, okay? 大王 Not just like the king, we don't say king, okay? We say what? We say 大王 Okay? Or you can say 国王大王 Or we say 天子 Wow!We can say 天子 yeah, maybe you hear this one, right? 天子，天子，天 is sky, right? 子 is a child, yes. 天的孩子 not a work, okay? The bigger person, okay? The Xia dynasty, in China is the first dynasty, from the BC, before Christ, 2070, okay?First dynasty and the first people person they say 天子 or you can say 大王 or you can say 国王 more popular like say 天子 why that's it they say I am the god kid 我是天的孩子 then after you guys you after me then you guys 我的孩子我的孩子 that means I am a top personperson, top person, 最大的那个人叫天子 or you can say 大王。那是什么 security 呢? Again, 世袭制。世袭制是什么意思呢? 世袭制是从哪来的呢?从下。世袭制是什么意思?就是说,如果你是天子,你是一个大王。If you are dead, 死了。Your brother can become 天子 or 大王 If I don't want my brother, then you want who? Your son, she's important. Then your son can become 大王 or 天子 And if your son died, your son have a kid, have a son or brother. Oh, now I know that. That means all the follow your family tree, nobody can become a 天子 Nobody can become a big person. 大王, right? Nope. Okay. If no, they just say, what is the creative? We say, 世袭字. Okay. China, we have this. 世袭字. From when? 夏 dynasty. And until 清 dynasty. Very long. Very long. If your family, who is a big person? 天子. Then your family just follow. Brother or son. And brother and son. The grandson, grandson, grandbrother, so son. Just follow family tree. In Chinese, we say, 世袭字. Okay, the form is 下. I want to say a little more. Why say them? Because we have some popular words here, okay? The words we say, you say what? You say, primitive security, right? Society, okay, society, okay. Primitive society. In Chinese, we say, 原始社会, before 夏 dynasty. Chinese, we say, 原始社会, primitive security. Chinese, we say, 原始社会, okay.Okay, again, that's the security, security, primitive security, right? Primitive security. It's a 社会. I not say dynasty. Dynasty is a 朝. Okay, so then that means before 夏, right? We say 原始社会. But really popular, how one word. That's I want to say down here. Which one?We say, 英雄不问出身、英雄不问出处。What is the meaning here? What is the meaning? 英雄 hero, right? Hero, you know that one, okay? And 不问, 问 is ask. 不问, don't ask. 出处, or 出身, 是名字, I don't ask your background. I don't care your parents from where.A big person, or you are rich, or you are poor. I just care you are hero, 英雄. 你是不是英雄? If 你是英雄, 如果你是英雄, you can become a big person, 大王. Okay, we follow you. That's nice, right? What is the rule? Okay, 这个, in that case, Chinese, we say, okay, we say,善让字 We love that. We love that. Okay. If you are a great person, if you are smart, if you are a hero, okay. We follow you. You can become a big person. 大王 国君 We follow you. Okay. This is 社会 This is a credity. Chinese we say 善让字善让字 Okay.We have a bigger person. That's a person named Yu. Yu, that person, okay. From the one, from the primitive security as a hero, okay. 他是一个英雄。他非常聪明,非常聪明。他 become a bigger person. 国君,大王。After, right?After he think, oh, I really like always my whole life is a big person, 大王, or 君子, or 国王, or 天子. Then he just think, if I am dead, I want my son become, my son's name is 启, okay? I want my son to become as a 天子.Then, after he died, then his son has become a 天子, okay, a big person. Then his son think, yeah, I like the son too. I want my whole life and my families, okay, become as a 天子. So, then his son, the son, and his grandson, right, become a 天子. Then that's why we don't have what?We don't have 善让字 We stop 善让字善让字 means Who is a hero? 英雄 Who can become a 大王 OK, they don't care your background. They don't care your parents. They don't care your family. They don't ask. Chinese, even right now, really like a popular. We really like to say, 英雄不问出身。如果你是 hero, 英雄 we don't ask you from where. We don't ask your family tree. Who's your family? How about your family tree? We don't care that. We care 你是不是英雄。如果你是英雄 you can become our 大王。We follow you. We say this one. We say 善让字 okay, 善让字 OK. This one from the 原始社会原始社会 primitive society 原始社会 primitive society 原始社会 We have a big person after youTotally changed. He's totally changed. How? Because his death, he wanted his son Qi become his 天子 or 大王. Then his son's death, he wanted his sons become the family families. That's why start beginning because it changed. Chinese we say 世袭制世袭字 means follow the families. And the Chinese follow this from down here. We see the dynasty, Xia dynasty, until Qin. So long time, you follow the 世袭字 Okay, 世袭字 we'll get here. Okay, the first dynasty is Xia. The second, we say Shang. Okay, Shang after Shang, we say what?We say 周 then 周 then finally we are 春秋战国 OK, it's 孔子是春秋战国时候的人那孔子是不是世袭制呢 Definitely, yes, OK, because 春秋战国 in the where, after 周 in the 周 there, and when we finished,世袭制 start 下 dynasty finish 清 dynasty long term is 世袭制春秋战国 still is 世袭制孔子是那个时候 Why you say that's one? I want to say 孔子的思想孔子的想法孔子的思想是什么思想？儒家思想。Finally, I think you know this one. Maybe you hear, oh, I know that. You are learning Chinese. If you are at one's level, I'm sure maybe you hear from somewhere. Okay, maybe you read somewhere. You know that? 儒家思想。儒家是什么思想？儒家是什么思想？是叫君君臣臣。父父子子 What is the meaning, YINGYING? 意思是说你要听话你要有礼貌孩子要听爸爸的爸爸要听国王的天子的意思是你不能不听话你一定得听话那国王听谁的国王听天的国王听他自己的那皇帝永远是皇帝这是那个时候的叫世袭制那孔子呢也尊敬这个制度说我呢既应该尊敬皇帝永远尊敬皇帝那皇帝呢死了以后还继续给他的儿子给他的孙子老百姓呢永远要这样跟着包了那孔子是希望和平孔子的想法就希望人们尊敬一个礼尊敬一个道德让人们 Please don't fight 别打仗 Why 孔子 not this one? Again 孔子在春秋鲁国的时候，天天打仗，每天打仗。孔子很穷，孔子说不想打仗 ，I don't want to。但是还是那个时候不停不停的打。孔子就是去跟国王讲话 ，No, I want the country to grow up bigger and bigger. I want the more of something, right? But that's why I have to fight. I have 打打 ，and that's why. 那这是孔子，那孔子生活的那个时候，那个地方是一个战争的年代，非常不平安。所以孔子的想法是非常希望和平，非常希望老百姓懂礼貌、懂礼仪、懂规定，这样老百姓就可以不打仗了。这个就是孔子那个时候的想法，叫儒家思想。儒家思想是谁创办呢？谁 create that here？ 孔子教人们有礼貌，懂规矩，孝顺父母，忠实于国王、天子。好了，那中国还有一个非常好的词，中国是从夏 dynasty， 如果 we talking about the dynasty， the first dynasty， remember， we say 夏， how we remember， maybe you hear some people， some Chinese， they say， 你是什么人呢？从哪来的？我是华夏之子，华是中华 Chinese， 夏夏丹的子体，对，的之的子孩子，我是华夏之子，意思名字 Chinese， the Chinese are from the 夏丹的子体，但是夏丹的子体 is first， 华 is 中华，华夏之子。之 is old words, okay? 之 in that case means 的 possibly as the 的华夏的子孩子，华夏的孩子意思名是 we the whole story from there, from the 夏 okay? So the 世袭制 we have still have another name, say what? 叫家天下 ，maybe you hear some of the saying here, right? We can say 世袭制 ，also we can say 家天下。家 as a family, right? Yeah, 天下 ，maybe you know that 天下 ，okay? Right now, still is really popular. 天下 is a country, okay? 大王会说这是我的天下，意思这是我的地方 ，my place。意思这是我的国家，国家。天 is sky, up the sky is ground, world, 就是下。那大王呢？那个天子呢？就是我是天的孩子。然后所有的 ground, 所有的世界 all world, 所有的地方都是我的。那这个天和下这个地方就全都是我的。天下就是 in Chinese 就是国家的意思。That right now we have a lot of meaning. I can say right now, if that's my room, right? That's my home, my room. I say, 这是我的天下，我的天下就这么大。Right? It's my room, your place. You can say, 我的天下 your family. You can say, 我的天下 your office, your place somewhere. You say, 我的天下。Okay, just in the depends. Okay. If you are a big person, right, the company is 你的天下。Okay, country.你的天下，天下 by itself is country， 天下 ，OK。Then from the 夏 dynasty， which is 世袭制 ，or we can say 家天下，家天下，国家，那个国家是他们家的，天下 is country run， 那个家，那个国家是他们家的 ，OK。So next father side the son continue。Son died, the grandson continue, or brother continue. Whole country just the families. The 家天下 whole people we just follow the families. You can say 世袭制 or you can say 家天下. I am watching some Chinese movie. Here they say 家天下 okay, or here they say 世袭制 That means start, beginning, 下 dynasty, and until some, until not some, 请 because all the big term Chinese say 家天下 or 世袭制 Okay, here? Okay, so finally, we just back here talking about the who? 孔子Before 孔子的 China 的 story, now we can continue talking about 孔子的春秋战国时期。孔子呢 we can review here again, 孔子非常非常的聪明。孔子说了很多了不起的话。Finally, we can more faster figure out 孔子 say what, 孔子说 what. 孔子有一本非常非常好的书。是论语这本书呢不是孔子写的是孔子的学生写的这本书写的是什么呢孔子在教学生的时候在和学生讲他的思想的时候他是什么思想儒家思想儒家思想教人们要怎么样啊有礼貌守规矩还有听话还有孝顺父母对父母也好爸爸妈妈要对孩子好孩子要尊敬父母父母要忠实于父大王 all 天子 careful here I have never seen 皇帝 right not there yet okay so here we just say 天子 all 大王 here right孔子的这本书是他的学生帮他写的那孔子写没写孔子没有写这个也是孔子死了以后很多年以后孔子的学生把老师说的话记下来那书主要是孔子讲的话孔子说我的思想我的想法学生就记下来了我的意思是这样子的还有就是学生问老师说怎么做呀为什么呢老师回答问题这个就是论语的那本书我们可以在下一次下一节课的时候开始 start beginning talking about the 论语 OK I see you guys next time